Rajiv Gandhi era. I had an opportunity to work with Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi very closely for almost 10 years. I must say, he was a great leader. I personally miss him. And he was a visionary. He had a vision of India in the 21st century, which made all of us proud of. In his era, beside many other things like Panchayat Raj, agriculture, and other institutions, we focused on telecom and IT. A lot of people used to laugh at us, saying, why India is focusing on telecom? IT will reduce jobs in India. All of those who criticize us today were criticizing us then also for wrong things. But now they are on the bandwagon of computers and software and telecom. Then we had 2 million telephones. It used to take 15 years to get telephone connection. With political will from Rajiv Gandhi, we decided to launch our own model of development in telecom, which was based on young Indian talent, indigenous development, local production, ancillary industry, rural telecom, STD PCOs, digital network. And I must tell you, in a short span of 20 years, now we have 900 million phones. We are a nation of connected billion. As a result of our emphasis on human capacity, we could also build simultaneously a huge software business. Now we have our own multinationals. We generate $120 billion worth of software and service export every year, year after year. We are well recognized all over the world as IT leaders, and people respect us for our talent. That's a great accomplishment. In Rajiv Gandhi's era, we introduced technology missions to really take technology to people. The idea was to use technology as the main input to bring about generational change in 6 areas. We had a technology mission on water, literacy, immunization, edible oil, telecom, and milk production, dairy development. On water, we decided to focus on 100,000 villages to provide them rural drinking water. Then people used to ask a simple question, what is so important about technology in water? So we focused on satellite imagery, geohydrological surveys for water sourcing. We created plants for excess iron removal, excess fluoride, water testing laboratories, and we used to have in our country guinea worm. We had almost 35,000 villages with guinea worm. It's a worm that comes out of your body, and this disease comes to you through waterborne, some kind of lava, which goes into your feet when you put your feet in the water. And the thing coming out of your body is almost like a spaghetti. And you take a pencil and roll it. You have to see it to believe it. 35,000 villages in India had guinea worm. We worked on it for many years and completely eradicated guinea worm. Nobody talks about it. Nobody even knows about it. That's the power of technology mission. We took technology as an entry point to bring about changes everywhere. We worked with voluntary agencies. We had missionaries with missionary zeals. We had a new management style. We went out to media to solicit their support. We travel around the country meeting with all the chief ministers. So we had state level missions, central level missions. And those were the most interesting and romantic days for people in technology. Then we had a mission on literacy. literacy mission was about bringing again technology into literacy. Simple things like dust-free chalk, plastic blackboard, solar power light. We spent a fair amount of time with voluntary agencies, and there were at one point in time 2 million volunteers on technology mission on literacy. That's the time when we kick-started this whole effort on literacy, when we had about 30-35% literacy. Today it is 75%. Took longer than we thought, but the seeds we planted did give significant results. Then we had immunization, where we had to provide 6 types of vaccines to immunize our children. Then we had 20 million pregnant women every year, year after year, to immunize, and 20 million children. We had no systems in place. I remember going to UP, where mothers would line up with their children for immunization, but mother's name doesn't appear in any documentation. They don't recognize them. They only recognize men. And none of these mothers will speak their husband's name. So we had to look at redesigning the forms. We had the largest number of polio patients in the world, and we were not making polio vaccine. So I remember going to Rajiv Gandhi as a prime minister once and said, "Sir, we don't make polio vaccine." And he said, "What would it take?" So we said about 300 crores. In those days, it was 10 rupees to a dollar, so $300 million. And he said, "Go do it." With his political will, we sent a team to Soviet Union and to France and started to blend vaccine. Today, 20 years down the road, not only we have eradicated polio completely from a country of 1.3 billion, but we are also the largest producer of vaccine in the world. That's a huge accomplishment. Then we looked at edible oil, because we were importing about $1 billion worth of oil at that time, mainly from Malaysia. And our job was to really shift a lot of our farmers into soybean, mustard, rapeseed, and other pulses to really produce oil seeds. I must tell you, we got a lot of support from our farmers. There was a time when we were importing $1 billion worth of oil, and we moved on to a point where we were exporting $600 million worth of oil cakes. We are again back to importing a lot of oil. So this is something we have to be on top of all the time. Telecom mission was something that I worked on it closely. It was a great success, and you all see the benefit today. Many of our young believe that the mobile phone is given to you as soon as you are born. But they don't remember that in our country, not too long ago, it used to take 15 years to get a telephone. And we had just about 2 million phones. Growing up, I had never used a telephone in my life. I used my first telephone in the US, because then in India, if somebody had a phone, he was too rich to be my friend, and I had no need to call anybody. I had never seen television in India in 64 because we didn't have one. And today there are 400 television channels and everybody has TV. And people say nothing got done in 60 years. Similarly in oil seeds, I mean in milk, Dr. Kurian, the legendary man, and his team really focused for long years on improving milk production. Today, we are the largest producer of milk in the world. But it took him 40 years to get there. I think the key message for the young people is that when you plant seeds, it takes a long time to get fruits. And sometimes you are not lucky to see the fruits. I've been lucky enough to see the fruits of telecom seeds that we planted. I may not be lucky enough to see the fruits of innovation seeds we are planting.